Welcome to this just-in-time video training series on the OLB setup process. In this video, we will be demonstrating how to install the OLB installation package. To understand where this step falls in the OLB setup process, please feel free to pause the video at this point. If you have not yet downloaded the OLB installation package from OTCnet online, please see a previous video in this series that demonstrates that process. In order to install the OLB installation package, we need to unzip the package, install the OLB certificate, and install the OLB installation file. Please note that these steps can be completed by any check processing users, including check capture administrators, check capture lead operators, check capture supervisors, and check capture operators. To install the OLB, we need to first locate the installation package that was downloaded from OTCnet online. If you do not have the OLB installation package downloaded onto your workstation, please work with your check capture administrator and together check out the previous video in this series demonstrating how to download the OLB. In this demonstration, the installation package has been saved to my desktop. As a quick reminder, the installation package needs to be downloaded onto every terminal and for each user that will be completing check processing activities. In other words, unless users share a universal login for a terminal, users that share the same terminal will need to each download and save the installation package to set up their OLB. There is an option available to run a multi-user command prompt that enables the IT administrator to download the OLB installation package for multiple users on a shared terminal. Please coordinate with your IT team if you wish to take this approach. For more information, check out the OLB training page on how to use the multi-user command prompt to download the installation package for multiple users on a shared terminal. Once you have located your installation package, there are three main steps that need to be taken to complete the OLB installation. The first step is to extract the files from this package. To extract the files, we can either right-click on the installation package and select Extract All, or we can double-click on the package, click Extract, and select Extract All from the toolbar area. Your file extraction program may look slightly different, but will still perform the same functionality. After selecting Extract All, another window will appear, prompting us to save the extracted files. We can save them either onto our desktop or in a personal folder that is easily accessible. In this demonstration, I am saving them to my desktop, and I am adding the word unzipped to the suggested file name. You can keep the file name the same if you would like. Once you have designated a place to save the files, you can click Extract. By extracting the key files from the installation package, we now have access to them and can proceed to the remaining steps to install the OLB. For the second step, we will need to install the OLB certificate. To install the OLB certificate, we need to right-click on the OLB certificate file we have just extracted and select Install Certificate. The certificate import wizard now appears. In this window, click Next. Under Certificate Store, in this next window prompt, we want to select the second radio button, Place All Certificates in the Following Store. You will notice after we have selected this option, the Browse button becomes active. Click Browse. Now we are prompted to select Certificate Store. In this window, select the second listing, Trusted Root Certification Authorities. Once you have selected it, click OK. Now click Next. Finally, you can click Finish. A window will appear confirming the successful installation of the OLB certificate. You can click OK. For the third step for the process of installing the OLB, we will need to return to the saved folder with the extracted files. right-click on the OLB application installation file. Windows administrator privileges are needed to complete the installation of this file. Please note that as the screen goes blank, I am entering in my Windows administrator privileges. We recommend that you reach out to your IT team for further assistance to install the OLB application installation file. The installation window will now appear. Click Next. Under Destination Location, click Next. Under Start Installation, click Next. Notice that the server port settings are pre-populated. They are calibrated to default and do not necessarily need to be changed. If you have different server port requirements and needs, please reach out to the customer service team. They will be able to assist you promptly. Click Next. The installation of the file is relatively quick, lasting anywhere from 30 seconds to a minute at most. When the installation is finished, you can click Finish. We have now completed installing the OLB application installation file. As we have now completed all three steps for the installation of the OLB, you will notice we now have two new icons on the desktop, the Start OTCnet Local Bridge and the Stop OTCnet Local Bridge. This confirms that we have successfully installed the OLB. To recap, in this video, we demonstrated how to install the OLB installation package by unzipping the package, installing the OLB certificate, and installing the OLB installation file. For further information, please visit the Fiscal Service website where you can find these and other resources to assist you in the OLB setup process. The next step in the OLB setup process is verifying the installation of the OLB certificate, which will be demonstrated in a following video. Thank you for watching. We hope this video has been a helpful resource. For additional information, please visit the Fiscal Service website.